Good afternoon, everyone. Today, the ATOM seminar has the great pleasure to welcome Professor Kenji Yasuoka. Professor Yasuoka obtained his PhD in Nagoya University in Japan and is currently a professor at the Department of Mechanical Engineering at Keio University, where he teaches courses about molecular dynamics simulations in both graduate and undergraduate levels. His research is focused on clarifying the phenomena of phase changes in the microscopic view using molecular simulation applied to hydrates, proteins, liquid crystals, and micelles. He also applies machine learning to efficiently evaluate and analyze the data obtained from molecular simulation. So once again, welcome, Professor Yasuoka. Thank you so much for accepting our invitation, and please feel free to start your presentation.
Today, so I talk about an acceleration and the analysis of the molecular dynamics simulation using machine learning. So I'm much acknowledged in some of the former students and the students, and then also collaborators. So before starting today's talk, I briefly explain our research topics and in using the molecular simulation, molecular dynamics simulation, sometimes in the Monte Carlo simulation. So here I show that several topics. Then, so first, I showed in the nucleation phenomena from the vapor to liquid phase. So initially in a uniform condition of the vapor phase, this is the water case. So I show the movie. I'm not sure it's good for see in your case. So after the quench in the temperature, we can see something clusters in a system. This is the nucleation phenomena and which occurs in initial state of the phase change. This is one of the phase change in the vapor to liquid phase. We also that done in liquid to solid, or this is the solidification, and then liquid to vapor, and then the bubble formation. So you can see in some of the cluster, the liquid droplet here. So we can calculate the nucleation rate, or also the critical nucleus. It is a very important value of the nucleation phenomena. So, and also we are interested in confined system. It is one of the confined system in the 2D system. It's graphene sheet, and two of the graphene sheet in the confined in the water liquid and the solid. So we just said checking in the phase diagram on the confined system. So we find in a very newly structure the very flat the ice case in this paper. And also we are also interested in confined this water methanol case, and then using the carbon nanotubes. So we push this side into the carbon nanotube. So usually in the methanol is fit to the carbon nanotubes, and then and mainly in the carbon methanol, and then there's some of the water case here through the carbon nanotube. But then we applied it in electric field, so we can see then only the water case, then and pushing up this side, then we can get in only the water molecules this side. This is a periodic boundary condition, so this side to come to the this side. So but we just pick up the water in this case. And also we are interested in biological molecules. This is one of the protein of the water channel protein. So we call them aquaporins. So I showed this side in the aquaporin in the membrane, the protein. So I'm not sure. So it's a very white molecule is in the membrane molecules, and then this in the green and the blue and the yellow and the orange is in the aquaporin. So water molecules in some sometimes in the push back to the out of the cell. So the bottom is the inside cell and then upper is out of the cell. So water molecules in the push out, sometimes in the push down in the water. So protein and then controlling already the through the water molecules. Yeah. That the color is just I put the red color and pink color to see the easily in the push out. So we are so much any kind of times in the molecular simulation, but today I have talk about the machine learning for the molecular simulation. So nowadays, and there are many researchers are interested in machine learning force, which is that initially you know, we get in the force using the DFT or something in quantum chemistry simulation. Then in we learn in the force using machine learning. That is a machine learning force field. So, but here we are another the direction, and in one of the acceleration of the molecular dynamics simulations, and then also the analysis of the molecular dimension data using machine learning. The first I explained in the first topic in the acceleration of the molecular dynamics simulation. So I think you know that well, and in our program on the molecular dynamics simulation, we use the MD simulation. The highly computational cost is in the large scale and in the long time MD simulations. So using the large scale, we can the parallelize in the system, then using the parallel massive parallel computing thing. So we also done in a large scale simulation in nucleation phenomena. That one is in about the 1 billion the particles in the system. It is not easy, but in we can do that in such kind of the large scale, such a large or more than the 1 billion, but here just 1 billion. So then it is possible. But how about in the acceleration of the long time MD simulation? So the people do research and then do that in the time evolution, and maybe accelerate then the MD simulation using the machine parallel computer. That means in the one step in the reduce in the time. There also some of them are using the merge time steps method, but still needed a long computational time. So here, we would like to know the Nobel method for the acceleration of the long time simulation. So we are thinking about these things. So then maybe 5 years ago, I think about these things in the more 10 or 20 years ago, but actually, 5 years ago, and I just explained in the student of my laboratory, so to who is in the Mr. Endo. So, what things? So, first, and then we get in the short time data. We can parallelize in the short getting the short time data, so many short time data. Then in the I just think about in the machine learning, meaning the prediction the something and using the data to the something. Then and so when we use in the short time data, we can that's a predict then the long time data using machine learning. That's in the my thinking the past time. So and Mr. Endo, it's possible, but other people know nothing. Then we discuss about many things, and then usually the long time simulation we do that we wait the long time. Sometimes in the 1 month, 3 months, and then the 1 year or something. But here we get in the short time memory simulation. We can parallelize as if we have the many computers or the cores or the CPUs. So then we can get in the many short MD simulation data using a parallelized computer. Then in the using machine learning and then predict in the long time data. So then we can reduce the calculation time data. Sometimes in the weekend, 20 times the faster and than the long time MD simulation. And here I explained it in the our method. So usually the MD data is the all of the molecules, then in the step by step, then we can get in data. But here we get in a short term data, then we call the future extraction, meaning we focus on the some of the molecules or and then some of the atoms and some of the particles, then in like that. Then also we don't need any more short time data. Then we skip in the time. Then we are using such kind of the data, then predict in part of the molecules or the particles, then in a step, then we can get it in a long time data. So we call that in that's machine learning method in the MD GAN, meaning that we use in GAN, and that is generated adversary networks, which is a very famous machine learning method. So it is more detailed of the MD GANs. So I'm not sure that you are interested in a more detailed machine learning method. So we published in the AI top conference to be AI, then please the check in this so more detail, but this is in the the problem in occurred in exposure bias, meaning we predict the one by one and in using a short time data, then in prediction that the data is a little bit far from the original one. So here it's we called it something and then tried something and then the point is time evolution the low dimensional latent variables use. So that is important. So we also the Wasserstein distance using that compare this discriminators. So one of that example using that mean square displacement of the polyethylene polymer chain. So this is the original data, the molecular simulation. We done that in maybe 1 year, 2 years. We get the many data. So the time and the MSC is like that. So and then. Here, when we use in the data set, the center of mass, and then here, then in red one is a generated data using the MD GAN. So dotted data is the original MD data. So violet the part, meaning we only use in the short time data, like 3 nanosecond, less than 3 nanosecond data. Then we predicted in more than 40 nanosecond or something more. Then here, this simulation in the 40 nanosecond is a linear the region. In the, this is a normal diffusion. So, but if we reduce in using the data, like 1 nanosecond, the violet part, then it's not so good for the prediction. If the prediction is a little bit different from the original data. So using the only the one particle here, then if that we using in the other more data, here is in the 100 the particles and in one molecules. So we want to predict in the center of the positions in particles in, and then we also use in 15th or 18th particle and the data. So then in we can reduce in the like 1 nanosecond, then like that. That means we put the more data in the machine learning, then machine learning know than this one. That means in polymers, a diffusion of the polymer using the aligning in this the molecules, then in we this part is very important for the diffusion. So we know that this one. So then we just put in such kind of data. And also the we tried it another the data and another system. This is in water diffusion in polymers. We focus on the water molecules, then in the polymer. The polymer is the glassy polymers. So polymer is not so much is moving, just in, so vibrating. So and then we do that some of them in the simulations, then in homopolymers and that such kind of things, and the polyethylene and PVDF, PVAC, PAM, and also the copolymer we also done in so. In the prediction. So show them in how to move them in the molecules. So original data is this is time and then that is just x coordination. Or we can if we can choose in the z, y and the same things. So you see then sometimes in the step and the jump or something. Because in the polymer is in the glassy and in the a little bit small pore in a polymer, then in the water in the jump something. They also the after using this and then we can predict in the data like that. So we can see them very similar in diffusion data, but also the it is not same. Because in the learning in the distribution of the moving, then in we generate in the data. So that is not the same, but in the distribution is the same. Then in we just check it in the distribution and in the x coordinate. So generated data is more clear than in, but target is also same things. Target is the original data. So I show that just MSD data in gray one is in using data, the size. Then red one is generating the dotted in the original target data. So we can get in very good results in the several conditions. So, and then we also like, can compare with the diffusion coefficient is like that. This is MD coefficient, and then this is generated diffusion coefficient using the MSD data. So it is the good result. Okay, so I move on then in the second topic, and in analysis of the molecular dynamic data using the machine learning. The first, and I show the unsupervised learning. The supervised learning, we know that in the answer, teach the answers, but here we the machine learning does know the answer. So when here we would like to compare the system, what difference is about this? So we pick up the system, example the system 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then we would like to compare the system, the what difference between these. So we pick up some of the dynamics. We call the local dynamics ensemble. That is in time sequential data of the point of the something in the inside in system. So we call it the local dynamic ensemble in system 0, or system 1, then system 2, and such kind of things. So example just the position of the yellow atom, then in the time sequential data is the position. Or also the time sequential data of the dipole moment also the possible, or the velocity or something. Yeah, we can choose something in the local dynamics. And that means in the time sequential data. So it means that we want to analyze or to clarify the difference, the dynamics, the differences between these. Then after choosing the dynamics, then we can compare with the system. So we use the distribution differences using the Wasserstein distance. So the S1 meaning the system 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we can get in a distance between these. So that in this case, and then 10 distance available. Also, after getting the distance like that, if this is a matrix, then it's hard to recognize in the distance. Then we put in the two-dimensional phase case, and then distance, and we call the embeddings in the two-dimensional. So it is easy to see then what difference between these. Also, we can get in some FIJ meaning in how difference between these. So, and the G is in this function. So, if that this is large, then the system, the both of system, the molecule in the both system, and in what difference between these. So, it means in that one is in blue one is in not so much. Moving in the example, then in the red is much moving. Then we can get this kind of the data and automatically using the machine learning. So it is one of that example, the first example. So we using more simple data, but in this one is in another one the example. We use a 20 amino acid solution and then one water bag case. So then that means in 21 systems we use that. Then also the 64 steps displacement of the dipole moment of the water, meaning we know that which is system has in which molecules in amino acid. But machine learning doesn't know that. We just use in the water molecules the displacement data. So then after that we get in Wasserstein distance and then embedding. Then the results in like that. So S0 is in the water bar case, S12 is a glutamine solution. It is much difference between these. So, and then five difference between these. So everyone knows in here in the dipole moment displacement, we can get in rotational time correlation functions, and then the correlation time, we can get in the correlation time. So in the S0, the correlation time is very short, is very fast in the moving the rotate. And but S12 in a glutamine solution, the water molecules, is a little bit slow. But also the machine learning knows how different between these. So and then if that near the glutamine molecules, then much different between from the bulk water case, then in a far from the molecules, then in a very similar the moving from the bulk water case. So it is automatically detect in these kind of things. So then the near the water molecules, near the protein, then amino acid, then water molecules is not so rotate in here. So then in this side it may rotate. So the other case, and we try to use in this the method to protein ligand prediction. We use in the one protein, and then in the several case of the and ligand. This is the 10 case of the ligand, and also no ligand case. Then we do that 11 the simulations case. So then in we get in the data for the protein and just mo several molecules in the protein. Then in how moving in that in the protein. So when we change in the ligand, and then protein the atoms in the different moving such kind of thing. So after using the machine learning of the calculating Wasserstein and distance and embedding this, it's then so color is in the binding affinities in the proteins, and we pick up in the data from the paper the free energy calculations. So that one is in the so lower maybe and minus meaning higher delta G, and then the blue one is lower in delta G. So you see in such kind of thing, the right hand side in a high affinity ligand, and then the left hand side a low affinity ligand. We can just separate it. So we can compare with in this PC1 in the machine learning axis, and then also the delta G. So the correlation is 0.82. It's not so bad. I think it's a good correlation. And also the we applied it much different case. This is prediction of the viscosity of the lubricant in the something. We choose in the four molecules, then in four share viscosity case, and then we get in the 16 on the system. So this is in the results of the original MD data, and the share this is the share viscosity, and then the shear, and then the shear velocity, and then this is the viscosity. Then so we can get in the shear thinning results. But if we do that, the other molecules, we need more data, more learning MD simulation. The here we do that machine learning, and then in the after getting the machine our Wasserstein distance and put in the embedding here. So we can see such kind of things. Then this axis and in the PC1, then we can compare with in viscosity. Then we can get in a very good correlation. But also you see the PC2, this axis is much different in the blue one and the others. So blue one is in a little bit spherical molecules, and then other is in hydrocarbon molecules in like a small long chain or something. Then we just think about this is the molecular differences, this axis. Then in we check in the time displacement in this side in like that. So from then in so that is the moving, that is near the solid, and then moving together. But this OMCT is in the moving in randomly, basically. So much difference between this, but this difference is not depending on the viscosities. Viscosity is the difference is from his. And also I showed in another case in classification the liquid surface in the solid surface, yeah, the ice vapor interface. We know that in ice pre melting here. So how pre melting the molecules in here. So we just check in such kind of things. So first in we done in the ice and the black one, and also the water and the yellow one. Then when we choose in the first layer, second layer, fourth, third layer, fourth layer, then we just check in how differences between from the ice. So the first layer and the blue one is very similar to the water case, but is not in the bulk water, a little bit near the solid, some of them near solid. And also the blue or light blue one, the fourth layer, you see in almost in the solid, but the third layer more so in the solid, but also the leaky. We can get such kind of things, and then this side in the region, like so we can green one and the second layer, this is second layer case, and the green one is in the solid, and then the blue one is the liquid, and light blue is in the middle. So then we can detect in the solid like and the liquid like and in the middle. So such kind of things using the machine learning. Okay, so we move on then in the third, maybe the second topic, the next on the second of the second topic with something. So we're using the supervised learning and using graph neural network. So and they show that in briefly in it. So we No, want to know the mechanism of the crystal formation. Then we want to know the the detect of the crystal or not. So sometimes we are interested in ice nucleation or cross rate hydrate nucleations. So and we can use the molecular data. So and in this case and we focus on the analysis for the solid liquid in the detection, and also the this is a hydrate in ice and then a hydrate. So the classification it is in a solid case. So we know that in some of them in such kind of order parameters here is a Q4, Q8. In the bond orientational order parameters for ice and water system, then we can see such kind of things. But we using in we need it in the water parameter before detection. Then in here, we would like to know in we do that in without the other parameters. So here we use in the graph neural network system, but also the graph neural network in the edge and the node. So and then and such kind of things. And then so but I was in a little bit is upgrade in this one in the machine learning method. So and we do that then here in the local structures, we pick up the local structures, the making in the graph, and then we use in the supervised learning and graph using graph neural network. Then in we can get classified this. So it's a latent but latent variable space in embedding here. So in the two dimensional case, so we can you can see the in here is a liquid and here is a structure one and the ice like that. Then we can classify these kind of things. So that was in a little bit different from the conventional graph neural networks. So because in graph neural networks using the node and the edge. So in the molecules, and sometimes need the bond angles here. So and then we use in the TNet, the Dr. Sakamoto and the developer here that we just reuse in this one. So using the detection that this. So that means not only the bond lengths, the bond vector is important. So it is a very interesting method. So here we use two of the ice case, ice IH, IC, and then the liquid, and then the hydrate, three type of the hydrate, structure one, structure two, structure H. So cross-site hydrate, it depends on the guest molecule, structure, depend on the guest molecules. Here is some put in a different to guest. Then we just use in the water molecules in cross-site hydrate. Then here, if that the only the liquid and the ice and the hydrate, we don't recognize in the ice and the ice IH, IAC, and also the S1, S2, SH. Then in just liquid, ice, hydrate, it is not so difficult. Maybe around in 5 million around one center of the one molecules, then in the around the four molecules, then on the seven and the six molecules, then we can recognize in the liquid ice hydrate. But it's hard to recognize the classifies in the structure of the structure as cross-site hydrate, structure one, structure two, structure H. So here you see that we needed more molecules in outside, yeah, surrounding the molecules. And also that also include the liquid and then ice one H, one C, and then structure one, two H, then in such kinds. But also that we can, after the 40 molecules, we can detect these kind of things. Then also the which I can show them in the phase in the latent variable space, so we can very divided in this. So here and then just ice and liquid hydrate is easy like that. And also the this one is a structure 1, 2, H, then in all of them in the ice 1H, 1C, and then structure 1, 2H, and then liquid. Then we can see such kind of things. But we call the dressing the order parameter. So, and then after machine learning, and then getting such kind of things. Yeah. Okay, so I'd like to summarize today's talk. Well, we have the two talk, then acceleration of the MD simulations, and then analysis of the MD data. So then for the acceleration of the MD simulations, so we use MD GAN, the physical properties in molecular systems can be predicted. So we're using the short data, then long data, and predict. The MD GAN is powerful tool for the prediction, the long time prediction. Also, the second topic is an analysis of MD data. The first topic in the using machine Wasserstein distance calculations, we successfully detect in the represented molecular behavior. It is potentially useful for the investigation, the new order parameters. And also the using the graph neural network, we use in one of the graph neural network, TNet, we classify the structures of the cluster hydrate, structure one, structure two, structure H, and also the ice one, ice C, and liquid also. This innovative approach providing the appealing and highly accurate placement for the traditional order parameters. Yeah, I hope that. Then also future goal and then fast and the automatic analysis too for the molecular data developed from the material research. We can approach the development of the material research. Okay, yeah, thank you very much in the hearing. So my talk, thank you very much.